I am so proud of you.
I'm kind of proud of myself, too.
Well, you should be. I challenged you to go the whole weekend without contacting me, and you did it. You see, this is what I was saying. You're stronger than you think.
Well, of course, it was hard. There were times where I wanted to call you.
Well, of course.
And when that happened, I wrote down what was scaring me and my level of distress.
Oh, well, that would be valuable to see.
Okay.
See, I think what this exercise demonstrates is that you're no longer a slave to your anxieties. Oh, great, great, great. But there's more. Just to confirm, what you've listed here are only the occasions when you would normally text or call me?
Most of them. I didn't always have a pen on me.
Great. Your writing is so small.
Gotta get up, gotta get out, gotta get home before the morning comes. What if I'm late? Got a big day, gotta get home before the sun comes up. Up and away, got a big day, sorry can't stay. I gotta run, run, yeah. Gotta get home, pick up the phone, gotta let the people know I'm gonna be late.
Michael's here, Dr. Storper.
Okay. Well, there's a lot of good stuff here. Wow. Maybe the list is a little bloated.
No, it isn't. I was painfully honest.
Well, good. Good for you. Now, the object of this exercise is to make you more independent. So we'll tackle something together, but I'll be more hands-off.
No, I want you to be hands-on. I want your hands on me.
Well, let's be aggressive, okay? Take on something hard. Heights.
Heights? No way.
Acrophobia is all over this list. See?
Yeah, but that's because it's my worst fear.
Exactly. We'll be systematic. We'll start with bridges. Then we'll do elevators, then balconies, and then finally, unprotected, high, open spaces.
This is not the best time to do heights. I got a lot of anxiety in my life right now, personal stuff with Claire.
We attack heights successfully, all your other anxieties will fall like dominoes.
Yeah, but this first domino is huge. I'm really, really not ready to do this.
I think you are.
I'm not.
I think you are. We'll start tomorrow. I know a perfect place, more than a bridge.
I feel really anxious.
Well, that's to be expected. If the anxiety gets any worse, just remember, don't text or call. Breaking Miguel's dependence is a challenge. To wean him from my teat, from the therapeutic teat, is a challenge. Loose teat reference. But forcing him to face a major fear demonstrates the progress he has made, that he is a different person than he was even a year ago. That we both are.
Your ex-wife is here.
What? She's, is she alone? Tell her I'm with a patient.
She's not here in reception, she just called. She's in the cafe downstairs.
There was no need to use the word here.
Okay. I'm sorry.
For what?
You know what for.
Honestly, I don't know. For having sex with your divorce lawyer? Or humiliating me in public? Or forever tainting the memory of the giant spider?
You made a scene, not me.
I made the scene? You made it. You made the scene. You're making another one now.
Please, I didn't come here to fight with you. I came here to make a peace offering.
What? Anthony's gonna waive his fee?
I want you to have the country house.
You love that house.
I know, but I can't go there. Too many memories. Anyway, I want us to become friends eventually, and so I thought this would demonstrate my goodwill. I've already signed the papers. It's all yours.
I don't know what to say. Bitch! Mm. She's a bitch!
Go with that feeling.
Why is she doing this? I've gone through every possible motive in my head.
No, you need to separate yourself from that woman.
We are separated. We're in the middle of a divorce.
Cut the emotional ties. Sell the damn house. Show her how free you are. You do this with people. You know that? You do it all the time. All the time. You depend on other people for your happiness. You did it with this bitch woman. You're doing it now with this patient, Mitchell.
It's Michael. And that's completely different?
Yeah.
I'm not dependent on him. I care for him, of course, naturally, after 15 years.
Pathetic rationalizations.
Is it possible to treat someone for 15 years without feeling some affection for them?
Of course. I feel nothing for my patients, nothing. It is the therapist's duty to separate himself emotionally. You understand? Otherwise, he can't be objective.
You've been seeing me for almost 10 years?
Yeah.
You feel no affection for me?
No, you're a special case.
Is that the phrase you use when a patient asks you that question?
Yes. Yeah.
What? No, I've never even been in the building on a weekend.
You have to come in. You're behind in your work. What, are you afraid of empty buildings?
No.
And then what?
It's just not a part of my normal routine. I have a routine.
It's ghosts, isn't it?
No.
Are you afraid of the ghosts of seniors who just wander the earth and come here with their inquiries?
No.
You know what, cowboy? I will tell Mr. Wren that you're too afraid to come in this weekend. Don't worry, I will only mention ghost if he asks. He will understand. There might be a slight adjustment in your pay.
What time do you want me here?
Let's say 11 a.m. Saturday.
Fine.
Good. Go team.
My mind is racing. There's a lot going on in here.
Like what?
I told you I got to go into work on the weekend. Could you come with me? Just get me into the building?
No, we're working towards your independence.
I know, but I'm doing really well with the not phoning or texting thing, and I thought,
you know. Exactly, you're doing really well. Remember, CBT is not about conquering fear. It's about, you know, learning to live with it, not letting it control you. Okay, I need you to cross the rest of the bridge on your own.
Seriously?
Yes, hands off, remember? You need to do this by yourself.
Well, where are you going?
I'm going back to the office.
Seriously? You're just going to leave me here?
I'm confident you can do this on your own. Now, I want you to cross three times. And remember, if you get the urge to contact me...
Yeah, don't. I get it.
Exactly. You're doing really well, Michael. I'm proud of you. Next time, we tackle the big one.
Yeah, awesome. Oh, please, God. Oh, please. It's not working.
Seriously?
Yeah, I can't. I'm not ready.
It's okay. I understand.
You know, they totally turned me on.
Mm-hmm, I know.
It's just it's our first time, and I want everything to be perfect, and I don't want my mind filled with other crap.
Yeah. Okay, sure. I just want to be clear that I want to have sex with you.
I want to have sex with you. That's not the problem.
Okay. So, let's be proactive.
Okay. It's just... Dr. Silver's being really cold lately. It feels like he's pushing me away. Does he hate me or something?
No, he doesn't hate you. Be rational.
He's totally ignoring this weekend at work thing. It's freaking me out.
What are you worried about?
What if I get locked in?
Use your key.
Well, what if there's a smoke with lots of fire and the firemen can't find me because of all the smoke?
Bring a whistle.
A whistle?
Yeah.
That's good. I should be writing this down. Hold on. Yeah. What else should I bring?
It's an Ativan. Cell phone, spare cell phone, battery.
Cell phone battery.
Granola bars, bottled water.
You know, you might want to start thinking about the end of the book.
Oh, I'm not there yet. I don't know. I can't wrap my head around that.
It's just that the end will affect how we shape the earlier chapters, particularly.
Fine. You want to talk about the end of the book? Fine.
Okay, you don't have to
just
get...
If things continue as they are, I'm willing to bet I'll only have to see Miguel once a week.
That's it?
Yes.
That's the worst ending I've ever heard of in my life. Nobody wants realistic David. They want to read how you cured him.
He doesn't have the flu. He has a complex social anxiety disorder. I can't cure him.
Okay, but you know what I'm saying.
Therapy is a process that never ends. It's about coping. It's about making life bearable.
No, you don't want this book to end because you don't want this relationship with this guy to end.
It's a profile of someone struggling with anxiety. It's not Bridges of Madison County.
Okay. You've obviously got something enormous up your ass, so let's just drop it.
I'm sorry. It's this country house situation. I've decided to sell, and I'm going up there this weekend to close it up. It's obviously weighing on my mind. I'm sorry.
Okay. I think that I should go up there with you.
What?
I think I should go up there. I think you need the company.
What's your anxiety level?
10.
Really?
This is a really big bridge.
A 10?
Okay, fine, 9. Please, don't make me do this. Can we just go back?
Come with me to the rail.
Okay, but hands-on. Can you be more hands-on, please?
Box breathing, visualize.
All these drivers going by, they're gonna think I'm a jumper.
They're not thinking that.
They're jerks.
You see? You're doing it. Doing it all by yourself.
I feel like I'm gonna throw up. Oh, I can't.
You're doing great.
No, I'm freaking out. Don't worry about me, I'll be fine. I'll see you on Tuesday.
Michael, don't do this.
Just stop pushing me so hard.
I'm not.
What the hell's going on anyway? It's like you hate me or something.
Michael, you're not thinking clearly.
Look, I don't know what I did that was wrong, but it's totally unfair for you to just be there for me all the time and then suddenly cut me off.
This is dangerous. Michael, this is dangerous. Don't. Michael, come back. This is a dangerous thing to do.
No. Come on!
Michael, no. Come down. Michael, I'm sorry. Not all exposures are successful. When faced with failure, it is tempting for the therapist to blame himself, but who can gauge another person's readiness to face their fears? The individual ultimately is the only one who can accurately judge whether or not the time is right.
Wow, David, this is fabulous. Perfect little escape. You sure you want to sell this place?
Well, it's not an escape anymore.
Ah, right. Memories. Well, they can't all be bad. Is this Stacia?
Stacia?
Oh, look how happy you are there. I just want to check out the pre-Sammy David. Is that okay? I promise I won't judge. Oh, my God.
Hi, David. Seriously, what the hell?
Going gumping?
What? No. I work here on the third floor.
So?
The stairwell is locked.
Take the elevator.
I have a problem with elevators.
And I have a problem with people who have problems.
My God, look at you. Wow, how old?
10 or 11.
Oh gosh, I just want to pinch those fat, freckled cheeks until they bleed. Oh, college, wow, you're thin as a rake. Same hair though. It's a shame, I was really hoping for a mullet.
This is really healthy, David. I'm really proud of you for letting me do this. Aha! Wedding day. This is what I was looking for. Oh, my God. You were handsome. You were a handsome guy.
David, the security guard, nothing's happening.
You gotta use your phone, genius.
I didn't bring my phone because I don't use the elevator.
Welcome to the crypt.
I didn't bring my phone. Can you call the elevator and I'll just ride it up to the floor?
No problem, cowboy.
Okay, just please hurry.
Memories can't be all that bad, huh? I mean, I know it's hard, but... Are you kidding me?
Oh, this is the only place you get a signal. We're here, so I'm just... And no messages, I'm done.
Jesus, David. This is sick. Every time you are in a difficult situation, you think of him.
It's not what I'm doing. He had a crisis.
He's constantly having crises.
Exactly. Exactly why I can't just put him out of my mind. Everybody thinks this is my problem. It isn't. He has issues. I've been pushing him too hard. Now he's in crisis. That's why I'm waving my phone in the air. That's why I worry about him. That's why I haven't told him about the book.
What? What did you just say?
We haven't talked about the book.
An idiot. God, David, he could sue. I don't believe it.
He's not going
to
sue.
No, listen to me. This is a serious situation, okay? Listen to me, you are in denial. You are dependent on this person, and you won't tell him about the book because you are afraid of losing him and being alone. Am I wrong? Huh? Am I wrong about this? Jesus, God damn it.
Carlos, I gotta go. No, there's something I have to do. I'm ready.
Ready?
I'm incredibly ready.
Thank you.
Life is full of bridges. Between people, between phases of life, between states of being. In Miguel's case, bridges are insurmountable obstacles. Miguel is afraid to cross, to separate from what is comfortable, because he finds great comfort in the familiar and has convinced himself that there is no great reward on the other side. Before we begin, I need to tell you something.
First, I need to apologize for yelling at you on the bridge. I couldn't figure out what you were doing. I thought you were trying to push me away.
No,
but I get it now. It's totally clear. You want me to be independent.
Yes.
Okay, you're not going to believe what happened. On the weekend, I went into work, and I rode the elevator by myself to the 18th floor.
Really?
And then I went right to Claire's, and we had sex. Amazing sex. And then I crossed the big bridge on my way here this morning. So that thing you were doing, the hardball approach, it totally worked. Okay? So, thank you. Now, you go.
Sorry?
You were gonna say something.
Right. I'm writing a book about you.
What?
I have been for 2 years, about you and your various fears. And it's going to be published very soon. How does that make you feel? Michael?